Every time I book an event, it sets in motion a system that creates all the documents and email reminders of everything my team and I need to remember. In general, you want to become disciplined at keeping good records, as this will save you a lot of time and hassle later on. A mentor once told me when I was getting started that a paper trail is a safe trail. It's important to get everything you've agreed to in writing. If you don't have it in writing, then it didn't or won't happen. Repeat business. Make new friends, but keep the old. Even if you're an excellent speaker, most clients will bring you back only after 3 or 4 years have passed. A lot of the same people attend yearly conferences, and event planners don't typically want audience members to hear the same speakers over and over again, which means for repeat business, you need a system to follow up with these people. If it fits with your industry, look for clients who have a new audience each year. For example, a few colleges and universities I work with have me come in every single year for new student orientation because it's a new audience every time. New staff trainings or orientations are settings where this also may apply, and if that's your ideal audience, it would be a good strategy to target these kinds of groups. Many speakers who have been in the industry for over 10 years tell me that 90% of their business is repeat. They just work with the same rotation of clients every 3 to 5 years, so maintaining these relationships really matters, and it's something you'll want to systematize as early as possible. Be great at what you do, be good to people, and keep following up. Do that, and you'll never have to worry about running out of speaking gigs again. Action plan. 1. Decide on your speaking fee and structure. 2. Create your speaker agreement, writer, event information form, and promo materials. 3. Create a great client experience by setting up a pre-event call and creating a one-sheet summary of the event details.